Trigonometric Integrals, Level 3. In the previous video, we continued solving trigonometric integrals of the form sine of x raised to the power of m times cosine of x raised to the power of n, where both m and n are positive integers. Up to this point, we covered two specific cases. The first case required the integrand to have powers of cosine that were odd and powers of sine that were even. The second case required the integrand to have powers of sine that were odd and powers of cosine that were even. This time around, we will cover the third case when both the powers on sine and cosine are odd. In essence, when you're face to face with an integral that contains powers of sine and cosine that are both positive and odd, you're free to use any of the first two methods established in the previous videos. Either case 1 or case 2 can be used to find the integral, where both sine and cosine contain odd powers. Let's illustrate this with an example. Find the integral of sine raised to the power of 5 times cosine raised to the power of 3 dx. Alright, notice that the integrand contains powers of sine and cosine. But this problem is slightly different than the ones we dealt in the previous videos. Up to this point, the natural thing to do was to identify the function that contained an odd power and decompose it into an even-powered factor and a single factor raised to the power of 1. In this example, both sine and cosine contain odd powers, specifically 5 and 3 respectively. These types of integrals are rarely encountered or tested, since the procedure to solve these integrals requires the same techniques that we used to solve the integrals from the previous video. When you encounter these types of integrals, it's totally up to you which trigonometric function you want to decompose. Let's first find the integral by decomposing sine of x raised to the power of 5. So we start by decomposing this function into an even-powered factor and a single factor of sine as follows. Next, we go ahead and rewrite the even-powered sine factor into powers of 2, so that we can then use the Pythagorean identity to replace even powers of sine into even powers of cosine. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Next, we go ahead and carry out the u substitution step. So we let u equal cosine of x. Then we go ahead and find the derivative of u with respect to x. And then it's just a matter of solving for sine of x dx. After that, we go ahead and use these expressions and substitute throughout. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Then we factor out the negative sign and expand the binomial as follows. From here, we simplify the expression by distributing u cubed. Then it's just a matter of finding the integral. We find the integral by applying the power rule for integration. Doing that, we obtain the following. Next, we go ahead and distribute the negative sign. The final step is to substitute back the original expression for u. In this case, we replace u with cosine of x. Doing that, we obtain the final answer equal to -1/4 times cosine raised to the power of 4 plus 2 over 6 times cosine raised to the power of 6 minus 1/8 times cosine raised to the power of 8 plus c. Notice that we solve this integral by using the second case when the power of sine is odd. Remember, we can actually solve this integral by using either case 1 or case 2. So let's go ahead and solve the same integral by using the first case when the power of cosine is odd. Using the procedure for case 1, we first need to decompose the cosine factor into an even-powered factor and a single factor raised to the power of 1, as follows. Next, we go ahead and use the Pythagorean identity, sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1, and solve for cosine squared. Then we go ahead and substitute cosine squared with an expression in terms of sine. Next, we carry out the substitution step by letting u equal sine of x. Then we find the derivative of u with respect to x, and solve for cosine of x dx. Next, we substitute these expressions throughout, as follows. The next step is to simplify the expression by distributing u raised to the power of 5. Once that has been taken care of, we go ahead and find the integral of the expression by using the power rule for integration. Doing that, we obtain the following. The final step is to substitute back the original expression for u. In this case, we need to substitute u for sine of x. Doing that, we obtain the final answer equal to 1/6 times sine raised to the power of 6 of x minus 1/8 times sine raised to the power of 8 of x plus c. Notice that this expression is slightly different than the one we obtained the first time around. Nevertheless, they are the same expression. If you still have doubts, you can always find the derivative of the expression along with trigonometric identities to obtain the original integrand. As you just saw, when dealing with powers of sine and cosine that are odd and positive, it's totally up to you which function you decide to decompose. In the end, you will be able to find the integral of the expression regardless of the choice you make. Personally, I always try to decompose the expression with a smaller exponent, since it will substantially cut down the number of steps required to find the integral. In general, if the power of cosine is odd and the power of sine is also odd, either of the methods mentioned for case 1 or case 2 can be used to find the integral. Usually, you want to decompose the expression that contains the smaller odd power, but you don't have to. It's totally up to you which expression you decide to decompose. This is the third of four cases that we will continue to cover throughout this video series. The one described here is when both the power on sine and cosine are odd. Alright, in our next video, we will go ahead and cover the fourth case, when both the powers on sine and cosine are even.